Net operating loss. Sounds like bad news, right? Well, it does have a bright side. If you don't have income, then you don't pay tax. And on top of not paying tax in the year of loss, a net operating loss gets carried forward to reduce future taxable income. You heard right. Net operating losses get carried forward and offset future taxable income. Remember, if it reduces taxable income later, it's a future tax savings, a deferred tax asset. So here's the shortcut. Net operating losses are always deferred tax assets. Let's see how this works with an example. The prompt reads, Apple has a net operating loss in year one of $100,000 and taxable income of $40,000 in year two and $80,000 in year three. The tax rate for all years is 21%. Provide the journal entries for years 1, 2, and 3. First, let's line up the information so it's easier to see. Put the years on one side and the amounts on the other. Net operating loss sounds bad, but here's the bright side. We don't pay tax in the year of loss, and net operating losses get carried forward and offset future taxable income, meaning we carry forward year one's negative $100,000 to reduce taxable income and the tax paid in year two. Negative $100,000 is big enough to cover all $40,000 of taxable income and then some. Can the net operating loss reduce taxable income to zero? Nope. Net operating losses only cover up to 80% of taxable income in any one year. $40,000 times 80% equals $32,000. That's the 80% limit in year two. Now we use $32,000 of the net operating loss. How much is left? Negative $100,000 plus $32,000 equals negative $68,000, which carries forward to year three. Can we use the entire $68,000 net operating loss to reduce year three's taxable income? Nope. Net operating losses only cover up to 80% of taxable income in any one year. $80,000 times 80% equals $64,000. That's the 80% limit. We just used $64,000 of the net operating loss. How much is left? Negative $68,000 plus $64,000 equals negative $4,000, which carries forward to future years. Let's take a step back and look at our calculations. Notice, net operating losses only get carried forward, and they get carried forward forever. Also, net operating losses only reduce future taxable income. Based on what we learned about temporary differences, we know items that reduce later taxable income create a tax savings, a deferred tax asset. So, net operating losses are always deferred tax assets. Lastly, use of a net operating loss is limited to 80% of taxable income in any one year. So, NOLs, carry forward only, always DTA, and 80% limit. That's it. Let's do the journal entries at December 31st Y1. So far, we learned there are two basic entries for tax, first for current, second for deferred. Let's start with the first entry for current income tax expense. Calculated as taxable income times the tax rate. In year one, taxable income is negative $100,000. We're calculating current income tax expense. Here, there is no income. Plug in zero. Remember, we have a progressive tax system. The more taxable income you have, the more you pay. If you have zero or a net operating loss, there's nothing to tax. And anything times zero is zero. So our first entry for current is nothing. You can't have tax expense if you don't have taxable income. Let's do the second entry for deferred. Remember the shortcut. Net operating loss, always a deferred tax asset. How much is it for? We have a net operating loss of $100,000. Is that what we're going to record? No way. We want the tax amount. We got to multiply by the tax rate. $100,000 times 21% equals $21,000 deferred tax asset. Asset increasing, debit. What's the other side of the entry? It's a credit for $21,000. Where's it going? Income tax expense. Take note, income tax expense shows up in every basic tax entry. The first entry for current, we have income tax expense. The second entry for deferred, we have income tax expense. And in the next video, you'll see the third journal entry for the allowance, we have income tax expense. So if you have an income tax question on FAR and you draw a blank on the account, see if plugging in income tax expense makes sense. First, you're done. Let's do the entries for December 31st, year two. For tax, we have two basic entries. First for current, second for deferred. Starting with the first entry for current income tax expense, calculated as taxable income times the tax rate. In year two, taxable income is $40,000 times 21% equals $8,400. Let's plug that into the journal entry. Income tax expense increasing. That's a debit, $8,400. What's the other side of the entry? Normally, it would be a credit to income tax payable. But in year two, are we going to pay the IRS $8,400? What's different about year two? We have a net operating loss from year one, which reduces taxable income and the tax paid in year two. Year one's net operating loss of $100,000 is big enough to cover all $40,000 of taxable income and then some. Can the net operating loss reduce tax payable to zero? Nope. Remember the 80% limit. Net operating losses only cover up to 80% of taxable income in any one year. For year two, we said it covers $32,000. Do we just plug $32,000 into the journal entry? No way! We want the tax amount we gotta multiply by the tax rate. $32,000 times 21% equals $6,720. That's the 80% limit. What account do we use? Deferred tax asset. We now use the deferred tax asset and make use of those future tax savings from last year. Deferred tax asset getting used, credit. Do our debits equal our credits? We have a difference and it's on the credit side. It's the difference between $8,400 and $6,720, which equals $1,680. What's this for? This is the remaining 20% that we still have to pay. Income tax payable. Let's look at our entry. The income tax expense for current is the same every time. It's just taxable income times the tax rate. The only thing that does change is that instead of a payable to the IRS for the full tax expense, we use the deferred tax asset. Before we move on, let's calculate the deferred tax balance. Year one, $21,000 debit. Year two, $6,720 credit equals $14,280. Let's do the second entry for deferred. Are there any new deferred items in year two? Nope. Were there any tax rate changes where we need to adjust our existing deferred tax balances? Nope. Then it's blank. Nothing new and no changes means no entry. Let's do the journal entries for December 31st, year three. For tax, we have two basic journal entries. First for current, second for deferred. Starting with the first entry for current income tax expense, calculated as taxable income times the tax rate. In year three, taxable income is $80,000 times 21% equals $16,800. Let's plug that into our journal entry. Income tax expense increasing. Debit, $16,800. What's the other side of the entry? Normally, it would be a credit to income tax payable. But in year three, do we pay the IRS $16,800? What's different about year three? We have a net operating loss balance from year two, which reduces taxable income and the tax paid in year three. Can we use the whole balance of $68,000? Nope. Net operating losses only cover up to 80% of taxable income in any one year. For year three, we said it covers $64,000. Do we plug this $64,000 into our journal entry? No way! We want the tax amount we gotta multiply by the tax rate. $64,000 times 21% equals $13,440. That's our 80% limit. What account do we use? The deferred tax asset. Deferred tax asset getting used, credit. Do our debits equal our credits? We have a difference and it's on the credit side. It's the difference between $16,800 and $13,440, which equals $3,360. What's this for? This is the remaining 20% that we still have to pay. Income tax payable. Let's look at our entry. The income tax expense for our current entry is the same every time. It's just taxable income times the tax rate. The only thing that does change is that instead of a payable to the IRS for the full tax expense, we use the deferred tax asset. Before we move on, note the deferred tax balance. Year two, ending balance, $14,280 debit. Year three, $13,440 credit equals $840 debit. Let's do our second entry for deferred. Are there any new deferred items in year three? Nope. Were there any tax rate changes where we need to adjust our existing deferred tax balances? Nope. then it's blank. Nothing new and no changes means no entry. Just to summarize, for net operating losses, carry forward only, always a deferred tax asset, and 80% limit. Next up, we'll review what happens when we think we won't use the deferred tax asset. You want to be sure to rack up these points on the exam. So don't go away. I'm Liz Cho with Test Prep in a Snap.